beyond the cattle trail. At the break of dawn, when the cry of the muazzin pierces through the silence of the night, Ali will rouse himself from his straw hat in his mad hat and head to the kraal to lead his father's cattle out to graze in the vast expanse of the savannah. There in the luscious outskirts of the village, where the grass is green and the rising sun is mellow, the lazy-looking animals would indulge themselves in the foliage, and Ali will find a spot under a shady tree to pass his time, and it is here that all the magic happens. Ali was a boy in a small village with not many people. His father had several sons who couldn't all go to school at the same time because someone had to take care of the cattle. So when one son was at school, the other was at home. But for Ali, it never mattered because he carried his school wherever he went. Sitting under that shade as his cattle grazes gracefully at a distance, he will pick out a book. He loved to read, to travel in time and place and see and feel and touch a world different from his own. He stood on the desert sands and watched as the pyramids rose to defy the skyline and proclaim the glory of the pharaohs. He stood in the Senate as Cicero proclaimed the might of an empire. He listen to the parables of Jesus of Judea. He traveled with Buddha throughout India. He heard the call of Confucius in China. He traveled with Muhammad of Arabia from Mecca to Medina. And then through the Middle Ages, he journeyed and witnessed King John sign the Magna Carta with a reluctant hand as his knights embarked upon the Crusades to capture the Holy Lands in Florence at the height of the Renaissance. Under the patronage of the Medici, he witnessed Da Vinci paint the Mona Lisa. Onto the door of Wittenberg, he stood as Martin Luther nailed his 95 theses. In Britannia, on stage at the Globe Theatre, he saw the genius of Master Shakespeare unravel. All the world is a stage, and all the men and women merely players. And then through Africa he traveled, through the gold kingdoms of Ghana, Mali, Songhai, through the ivory cities of Mogadishu, Mombasa, Zanzibar, through the stone walls of Great Zimbabwe, back in Timbuktu he heard the griot sing the praise songs of Mansa Musa. Mansa Musa, hey, Mansa Musa, oh, Mansa Musa. And then he journeyed on and saw the Ottomans change Constantinople to Istanbul. He stood in awe as the Taj Mahal rose to the glory of Mumtaz Mahal. He heard the praise songs of Kublai Khan and Genghis Khan as he traveled along the Silk Route with Marco Polo before the Ming Empress drove away the Mongols and made the Great Walls of China even greater. In Japan's bustling city of Kyoto, he saw the samurais with their two blades, the geishas with their alluring gaze as the actors in their kimonos danced the his cattle trail. How is it that a young boy in some faraway village herding his cattle can know so much about the world, can appreciate the beauty and diversity and complexity of the human experience? Simple through the power of the page. Sitting under that shade, flipping through those pages, opened up his mind to the endless possibilities of this world and gave him the power to dream like any young person in any urban suburb of the world. And so today we remember the young boy from Golu who traversed the limitations of his small town and became an icon on the national and global stage. We remember the boy who held on to the illuminating pursuit of knowledge, who empowered himself to empower his people and his nation. Today we celebrate a statesman, a man who lived his life in the service of his country, who rose to the ranks to the highest office of the land. And despite his sojourn thereof, he showed us the possibility of honor and integrity in office. Today we remember. Today we honor. Today we celebrate. Today we revive the name and the legacy of a forgotten hero, a pioneer, a visionary, a consummate servant of the civil, a scholar, a diplomat, a statesman. Today we honor Dr. Hilla Limann.